Good morning, friends. In today's class, how are you? How are you? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to visualize me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So today's class, it will be a live class in Google Meet. So in this class, we will discuss about the construction of a epicycler. So in previous classes, we have discussed with the construction of various engineering curves. So generally, you can see that engineering curves can be classified into two categories, that is conic curves, and then the next one is the special curves. In case of conic curves, we have discussed about parabola, hyperbola, and ellipse. And in today's class, we can go into the special curves. The special curves mean that cycloid, epicycloid, hypocycloid. Can see that the cycloid, epicycloid, and hypocycloid. These three curves are the curves which mainly form the special curves. Apart from this special curve, we are having one more curve called as involute. Involute of a circle, involute of a square, involute of any polygon. So these are called as special curves. These special curves are used in engineering applications. So you can see that in case of gear tool. So you might have seen a gear in case of an automobile engine. In case of any small mechanical applications, you would have seen the gear. So in case of getting this gear tooth profile, you will find the application of this kind of curves. That is cycloid, this epicycloid, and hypocycloid. All these curves, you will find applications in gear tooth profile manufacturing. Okay. And the involutes also find their application in gear tooth manufacturing as well as in case of cam profiles. Cam is a special mechanism which is used in the IC engines. So this cam profiles, for manufacturing of this cam profiles, we need this kind of special curves. Okay. So in previous session, we have discussed how to construct a cycloid. By Dr. Shankar. In this class, we will go for epicycloid. First, initially, I will brief you what is cycloid, what is epicycloid, and what is hypocycloid. So, you can see that this one, cycloid. So, in previous class, we have discussed about this cycloid. When a small circle of certain diameter rolls for one complete revolution, so when it rotates like this, in this direction, in the clockwise direction, through one complete revolution, and it comes to this position. If you take any arbitrary point A in this small circle, this point A, for one complete revolution, it will trace a path. So the path traced by this point A for one complete revolution is called as a cycloid. Okay. Then epicycloid. So you can see the same circle, small circle, when this circle goes for one complete revolution in this clockwise direction, above another large circle. You can see that if you complete this, this one will become a large circle. A large diameter circle is there. Above that circle, when this small circle goes for one complete revolution, again, a point A in this circumference of this circle will trace a curve. This curve is called as epicycloid. Okay. Then, the same diameter of small circle, when it revolves for one complete revolution inside the large diameter circle. If you see that, this is the large diameter circle. In this large diameter circle, inside this large diameter circle, the small circle revolves in the anti-clockwise direction. For one complete revolution. Now the path traced by a point A on this small circle is this one. So this is called as the hypocycloid. So these are the different engineering special curves. Okay, in today's class, we will see exclusively the construction of a epicycloid. Construction of a epicycloid. Now we can construct a epicycloid. So let us imagine that a small circle of diameter 50, a small circle of diameter D is equal to 50 mm, it rolls for one complete revolution over a large circle of diameter 180. So capital D is 180 mm. So you can automatically say that the radius of the small circle is 25 and the radius of the large circle is 90. Okay. So here the large circle is called as the directing circle. It's called as the directing circle, and the small circle is called as the generating circle. Now you construct the large circle, that is the directing circle of radius 90. So let me take an arbitrary point, this one C. We take an arbitrary point C. With this point C as center and 90 mm as radius, 90 mm as radius, let me construct an arc. Let me construct an arc like this, okay? So this is with C as center and 90 mm as radius, you construct an arc. Take an arbitrary point here. Let the point be A. Join AC. Join AC. Okay. And extend AC. Extend AC. And now you have these. Diameter of the small circle is 50 mm, so its radius is 25. So you take the radius 25 mm in your compass, and from A you cut an arc here of 25 mm radius. Let this point be O. Let this point be. Now with O as center and 25 mm radius, you complete the generating circle. So with O as center and 25 mm as radius, I complete the generating circle. So this is my generating circle. This is the generating circle. Now I have constructed the generating circle of radius 25 mm. Okay. Now this circle need to be split into 12 equal segments. So how will you split a circle into 12 equal segments? So you know that in circle it is totally 360 degree. So you can split this into like this. So a horizontal line can be drawn like this, and further this segment can be divided. Each segment can be divided into three more segments. So totally you will get 12 segments. So how to get it? So 30 degree and then another 30 degree. So you can see that you can join this and join this and extend further. This one can be extended further. Similarly here, from here it is 30 degree and again another 30 degree. So each segment is of 30 degree. Yeah, fine. So now I have split. So now I have split up the circle into 12 equal segments. Okay, now you name these segments. So this one, this is 1, this one is 2, this one is 3. Then this one is 4, 5, 6, 7, and this one is 8, 9, 10, and this one is 11. So totally I have split the circle into 12 segments. Okay. Now I have to take that when this circle revolves over the large diameter circle, which is of radius 90, for one complete revolution, what will be the angle subtended by it? So that angle I have to determine. The angle can be determined by the relation theta divided by 360 equal to 2 pi small r by 2 pi capital R. Okay, right. You know that the small r is 25 mm. The capital R is 90 mm. So here the 2 pi gets cancelled. So theta is equal to 360 into small r divided by capital R, which is equal to 360 into small r is 25 divided by capital R is 90. So what you will get? So here we get 100 degrees. Get 100 degrees. So theta is equal to 100. The angle theta subtended for one complete revolution of the small generating circle over the directing circle is 100 degrees. So with this point C, from here this point C, you take 100 degrees. You take 100 degrees. So let me take like this. So this angle is 100 degree. This angle is 100. Theta is equal to 100 degrees. Okay. Right. So now we can theta is equal to 100 degree. So this is the position of the circle after one complete revolution. So I can construct that particular circle here also. So the same circle I can construct here, but by using dotted lines. Using dotted lines, I can construct this circle. Okay. So after one complete revolution, the circle will come to this position. Let this position be named as point B. Point B. And the center point of that circle may be named as D. May be named as D. Now with C as center, with C as center and OC as radius. That is 90 plus. So this one is 90, right? This one is 90. So AC is 90, 90 plus 25. So that thing as radius, you can say that you can construct an arc. You can construct an arc like this. You can construct an arc like this. So with C as center and OC as radius, you can see that I have constructed an arc up to D. Okay. Similarly, you can construct the arcs from 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6 with C as center and C11 as radius. You can construct arc with C as center and C10 as radius. You can construct arcs. So these arcs will pass through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 respectively. So you can see that how I construct the arcs. Now with C as center and C11 as radius, you construct an arc that will pass through 1. That will pass through 1. So you can see that the arc will come like this. Then with C as center and C10 as radius, you can construct an arc that will pass through 2. See, is passing through 2. Okay. So,
sir.
Yes. Yes.
Sir, video clear under sir.
Video.
Clear under any body sir.
Okay. Okay. I will again. You can watch this video. After that, later on, I will put it the recorded video in the classroom, in the Moodle classroom. I will put the recorded video so that you can visualize very slowly and you can see it neatly. Afterwards, we will construct it in using the mini drafter in the drawing sheet. That thing will be further clear. Okay. So this is just for a to get a classroom appearance. Okay. Right. Then with C as center and C8 as C9 as radius, we construct the arc which will pass like this. Yeah. Then with C as center and C8 as radius, you can construct the arc. So this will come like this. Then with C as center and C7 as radius, you can construct an arc which passes through 5. Then final one is with C as center and C6 as radius. C6 as radius, you can complete the arcs. Okay. So now this is the path traced by each and every points like 11, 10, 9, 8, all these points, when the generating circle revolves for one complete revolution. Okay, right. Now you have to split this angle 100 degree into 12 equal halves, because since we have split this circle into 12 equal segments. So, this angle, this theta equal to 100, this angle has to be split up into 12 equal segments. So, how we can divide it? So, 100 divided by 12, we will get approximately 8.33 degrees. So, 8.33 degrees. Each segment will be of angle 8.33 degrees. But dividing 8.33 using a protractor, it is difficult. So we have to go for geometric procedure for dividing these angles into equal segments. But initially, I will give you a simple method. So here you have 100 degrees. This can be split into its half, that is 50 degree. So 50 degree, you draw a line. You draw a line for 50 degrees. Which you get it for 50. Okay, right. So now this part will be 50 and this one will be 50. Further, you divide this into 25, 25. Okay. So it can be divided into 25. So this angle is, this is 25, this is 25. Similarly, this half also you divide it into 25. Now the total 100 degree is divided into 4 equal segments. Now this 4 segments, each segment can be divided into 3 more segments. So how it is? So this is 25, so 8.33. So if you have 3 8.33 segments, that will be good. So we can divide accordingly. So I have splitted it into 3 segments and this part into 3 segments. And here also 3 segments, this one also 3 segments. So now I have divided the entire things into 12 equal segments. 12 equal segments. Now you can name this. Can name this. This one can be named as O1. This can be named as O2. This is O3. This one is O4. O5. This one is O6. And this one O7. This one is O8. O9. This one O10. This one is O11. So totally you have 11 center points from O1 to O11. From O1 to O11. So now here with O1 as center, with O1 as center, and this OA is nothing but 25 mm. 25 mm is OA, its radius. So with 25 mm as radius and O1 as center, you take your compass. With O1 as center, you cut an arc which passes through the point 1, which passes through the point 1 on the generating cell. So let me cut the arc here. So this particular point is 1". This is 1". Then with O2 as center and the same radius, OA, 25 mm. So with O2 as center, you cut an arc which passes through the curve through 2. So this is 2". Then with O3 as center and the same radius OA, you cut an arc which passes through the point 3. So that will be 3". So you can see that this is 1". This is 2". This is 3". Then similarly, with O4, O5, O6 as centers and OA as radius, you can cut corresponding arcs which passes through the corresponding points. So here, O4 as center and through the curve passing through 4, OA as radius, you can cut an arc. So this will be 4". Then O5, you can cut. This is 5". And then 6, can cut the arc, that is 6". With O7 as center and OA as radius, you can cut the arc which passes through the point 7. So with this O7 through, you can cut. So this is 7". Similarly from O8, this is 8". And this is 9". And with O10 as center, and through the curve passing through 10, you can cut an arc. So that is, this is 10". And if with the O11, you can cut an arc which is passing through the 11. So I have marked all the points. Now you have to join all these points using a smooth curve. Initially using 2H pencils, thin curves you have to join, then later on you can make it thick, okay? Right. So now I started from 1, from A, let me join 1, and then let me join 2, and then let me join 3, then 4, 5, and then 6 and 7, 8, and then from 8, 9, 10, 11, and then 2B. So now you can see that I have joined the curve using black marker. You can see that how does the path traced by the point A forms a curve called as the epicycloid. Okay. So the curve traced by the black color, which I have represented in black color, represents the epicycloid. So now if you want, you can construct a normal and a tangent to this curve epicycloid at any point on the curve. So let me take any arbitrary point. at this point be P. Arbitrary point P on the curve. So now you take this again OA as radius. Again you take OA as radius with P as center and OA as radius. You cut an arc here. You cut an arc here. Let this point be E. Let this point be E. So now you try to join this point E. Try to join this point E with your center of the directing circle. So you get a point here on the curve AB. So that point is called as N. That is N. Now if you join this N with P, you join this point N with P, that is the normal. That is the normal to this curve. If you draw a line at 90 degrees to this normal line, that will be your tangent. That will be your tangent. So this is the tangent. This is how you need to construct a normal and a tangent to the curve epicycloid. I think whether you understood the concept of epicycloid here. So when compared to parabola, ellipse and hyperbola, this curve epicycloid, hypocycloid seem to be a little bit tough. But once you practice the procedure, it is only very simple. It is only simple. Because the studying this kind of engineering curve, that too a special curve, is very very important in engineering point of view and engineering point of applications. Okay, right. Thank you for this lecture. Later on I will come into the class again. So you remain in the Google Classroom. I will come again. Okay.